Welcome back to another video. My name's Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make videos for non-techies. And in this video, I'm going to talk about the different options to host videos on your website, but more specifically, your online course or your sales pages for your website, where a simple YouTube might not do. Now, what you're looking at right now is one of my done-for-you templates that I recently released, and it's been a smash hit. And what it allows you to do is launch an online course on your website, and it's got everything you need: professional design, a page builder, an entire learning management system, and it's all in this free done-for-you template that you can get right now on my website. And one of the biggest questions I've been getting is, what's the best way to host videos for your online course? And I just wanted to cover that real quick in this video. I want to do my best to go over all the options, make it as concise as possible so I don't keep you here for an hour explaining this topic. So there's several options of where to put your videos, and I'm going to go over those, and they all have pros and cons, and I'm going to try to go through each one and say some of the pros and some of the cons. So I'm going to try to do this kind of quick. The first one is obviously YouTube. Now, YouTube is an excellent video host. It has no cost at whatsoever. You just get an account, upload your video. They're going to make it mobile responsive, and they have a great delivery network. Now, the negatives are you get all that YouTube branding. You can't customize the video player. It's very easy to find the direct link back on YouTube so that you can have people stealing your content. So someone pays for your course, they're watching a video, they can get the direct link to YouTube, and they can share that direct link on YouTube to anyone that they want to. And that's why YouTube is usually not a good option if you have a paid course. So that is YouTube. The next one that you hear a lot is Vimeo. Now, Vimeo has a free service that's exactly like YouTube, but the only difference is they also have paid plans that overcome a lot of these problems that you would get with YouTube for your course. So here's Vimeo Pro. It's $199 per year. A little expensive if you ask me, but you can host as many videos as you want. You can customize the player, so you can add your brand's colors to the player, which is really nice. You can restrict what website you can embed the video on, so it's kind of secure on your website. And I think they give you some basic stats. I think maybe just how many views. It probably doesn't go into much more detail than that. So it's a good general video host, but then they don't really give you marketing options or any features that are specific for an online course. So that's Vimeo. And the next one is Wistia. Now, Wistia is actually very expensive, and it's interesting because you had this other options, and then Wistia comes into play, and they have more of a marketing-centric platform, but it comes at a very high cost. Now, they do have a free plan, but it's very limited. It only gets you about 5 videos, and you can pay for a pro plan. It's going to get you about 150 videos, still kind of limited if you ask me, and it's $100 a month. That's a lot of money if you ask me. Now, you do get to brand the player, so you can change the colors. It's unbranded. It's not going to say Wistia, and I'm talking about the pro plan, not the free plan. That has branding and all that kind of stuff. But for the pro plan, you can customize the player. It's kind of nice that they do that. And there's some good analytics behind it. I've heard people say that they get really good analytics out of Wistia, but it comes at a very high cost, if you ask me. $100 a month is a lot of money. Unless your course is bringing in 6 or 7 figures, I think $100 a month is a lot for what you get. Now, there's other options that are very technical. So you might hear, get Amazon S3, but it's very technical to have Amazon S3. It's not easy. And there's also some really outdated video platforms out there. One that was very big with marketers, but hasn't been updated in probably like 3 or 4 years, is called Easy Video Suite. I actually own it. It's actually pretty lousy compared, because it just fell behind the times and it wasn't updated. And that's Easy Video Suite, and it's expensive. I think it's like $400. And you still have the cost of putting your videos on Amazon S3, and it's very technical. Now, I just showed you all of these options. Oh, and one last option, you can just upload your video as long as it's under the limit that your host gives you, the upload limit to WordPress. You can just slap your video right in WordPress and you can host it that way, but you don't get the security and you don't get any features, analytics, or options or anything like that. So these are some of your options. Now let me show you what I use. I use something called VooPlayer. Now right here, I'm logged into the back end of VooPlayer. Now I'm not going to go to the front end. If you go to VooPlayer.com, you can read through all the different features. There are so many features that are geared towards marketers, online course creators, and I'm going to show you how I use VooPlayer. Now let me clarify what VooPlayer is and what it is not. VooPlayer is not a video host, so you don't actually host your video on VooPlayer, but I'm going to explain why that's a good thing. So you don't host it on VooPlayer. Another caveat with VooPlayer is if you go to their website, it shows that it costs $197 per year. However, a year ago when I bought VooPlayer, I also paid a lot of money for a reseller account, which means I have the right and the ability to resell 60 VooPlayer accounts, and I can charge a one-time fee. So instead of paying $197 per year, you can go to my website, buy a VooPlayer account. It's only going to cost you $99, and that's a one-time fee. It's not annual. There's nothing monthly. It's a one-time fee. The only limit you get on that is how many views per month, and that's going to allow you to have 135,000 views per month, and that is such a huge limit. I don't know anyone that would really even hit 125,000 views per month. Or did I say 35? It's actually 135, but I might have said 125. Anyways, you can see I'm actually logged in. Here it is right there, 135. So if you want to see the features, all the full feature list of VooPlayer, you can go to their website and look at those features, but you wouldn't probably want to buy it there unless you want to pay $197 per year. Instead, you can buy it on my website. It's going to cost you $99, and it's a one-time fee. When you do order it, I have to manually create the accounts. Now, let me show you why I use VooPlayer and how I use VooPlayer. Okay, so when you first log into the back end, you would be clicking on Add New Video right here where it says New Video. And what you would do here is the first step is we're going to give this video player a name. So I'm just going to call this Test. And you can group your videos right here. I obviously don't have any videos, so I don't have any groups. And right here's where you're going to put in the URL to your video. Now, you can host your video anywhere you want. So if you wanted it on Amazon S3, you could do that. And what they do that's unique is you can even put your video on Dropbox. So you can have a free Dropbox account, copy and paste the public URL right here, and it can actually stream a Dropbox video. A video that's on Dropbox, it can stream a video that's on Google Drive. I've never used the Google Drive, I've used the Dropbox. And what's really neat is you can actually put a YouTube link in here and you can stream a video from YouTube. Now, the difference of doing it through VooPlayer versus YouTube Direct is on VooPlayer, it's going to strip out all of the video branding from YouTube and their video player. And it's going to basically, someone's not even going to know they're on YouTube. So you can literally create a new account on YouTube, upload your videos there, leave your videos on unlisted, copy and paste it into here, and serve those videos in your course via VooPlayer. And it's a beautiful setup. And that's how I have all of my videos that I use with VooPlayer. I have them on a separate YouTube account. They're left unlisted. And the reason you're not violating any YouTube terms of service is because when someone clicks play or is watching your video, it's actually first flowing through VooPlayer and then to your website with zero delay. So you get all the benefits of YouTube's free video hosting platform, but you don't have to deal with the branding. You don't have to deal with any of that stuff, the player. So let me just show you how I would do that. So let me go over to YouTube and I'm on their trending videos. I'm just going to take this first one here. I'm going to copy the link and I'm going to go back here and I'm going to paste it right there. And what's nice is, obviously, if you have a lot of videos in VU Player, you can go here and you can set all your settings in one video and then copy those over to each new video. And that's going to be like your player colors and stuff like that. I'll show you that in a minute. Obviously, I don't have any here, but this is a feature that I use all the time. You can put a custom thumbnail right here, or I can just click on auto-generate and it pulls it right off of where it is. And here you can choose the dimensions of the video, or you can say here, just make it auto-adjust. So in WordPress, it'll just go the full width of the container that it's in. Let me just choose this right here, and then I'm going to go ahead and click on update. So that's the first step in getting your video, and then it kind of shows you a little sample of it right here. Now, I'm going to go back into the basic settings. And right here is where you would change the player color. So you can change this yellow. There's that bar on the bottom. That's going to be black. You can change that color. It's right here. And then the little progress indicator, it's this red here. And you can change all these colors by just dropping in your color code. So let me change that. So that's where you really want to get your brand's colors in there. So here are some of the advanced settings, and a lot of them I don't use, but I'm just going to say what they are. Live streaming, that's where you can give the impression that it's a live event and it's only available during a certain time. Watch and win contest, I don't use that. Finish action, I do use that. And what this allows you to do is once the video gets to the end, an action can be performed. Now, the way I use this is for affiliate marketing. When the video gets to the end, I have it redirect over to the affiliate offer that I might be talking about in the video. And you just literally turn this on and you get this pop-up, and here's the different actions: redirect to a URL, show HTML, show image, or you can repeat the video. So let me turn that back off. Image on pause, that's cool. When someone pauses it, you can, instead of them seeing just whatever frame they are in the video, you can have it show an image as soon as they pause. I don't overlay a logo. I don't use this SMS gate. You can show or hide controls if you want. Full screen, this gives them the option to choose full screen. Autoplay, I do use the autoplay, so when someone goes to a page with the video, it automatically starts playing. I always use this auto buffer, so the minute they go to a page with my video, it starts downloading the video immediately, so there's no delay when they click on play. If it's a case where they have seen some of the video or I don't have autoplay on. Show border, I always turn this off. There's a little border and some kind of a like a frosting look there. Or shadow, I'm sorry. I'm going to disable that, and you can see that will all go away. Disable pause. People get annoyed if you disable the pause. Smart play, this is the money feature. If you have an online course, what it's going to allow you to do is if you have a lesson with a video, someone watches half the video, leaves, and then comes back, it's going to remember where they left off. And of course, this is dependent upon cookies and things like that. So if someone's in a browser where they delete all the cookies and all that kind of stuff each time they close the browser and log back in, they wouldn't be getting the benefit of this feature, but most people don't work like that. I know I don't. So always have that on. Overlay sharing buttons, I don't do that. Pulsating button, I do use this, and when I turn it on, it's going to go from this play button to a pulsating button like that. I wish you could customize the color, but you can't. So I'm pretty happy with that. Auto pause, this is if someone is on a page with your video and your video's in the viewport and then they scroll past your video, the video can automatically pause. And then disable force field, I actually don't even know what that is. So let me close these settings, and now I'm going to go to the tracking settings. And you can drop basically a Facebook retargeting pixel if someone gets to a certain point in the video, and you can do some real tricked out marketing stuff like that. And right here you can have options happen as someone is watching the video. So this is a timeline of the video, and you can have these various options happen, like the video gets locked and they have to give an email, or the video gets locked and then they've got to give a social share, or various different actions. I usually don't use this. So all you have to do is click on save video, and then you can click on publish right here, and it gives you three options. It gives you this code right here that you can just copy and paste into your website, and it would embed that video in there. here's a feature I've never used, so I can't speak on it, but it allows you to play the video in a pop-up. And then here's a link where you could just paste it on Facebook. I wouldn't recommend doing this Facebook feature, though. I think I tried it once. I didn't like how it worked. If you want to put video on Facebook, just put it on Facebook. So I got that into my clipboard. And let me now log into a WordPress site. So here I am on a WordPress site. I'm actually going to do a video on a plugin in a moment. And so let me go to Pages. Let me click on Home. And I like to put code in the text tab, not the visual tab here. So I like to put in the text. So let me remove what's there. Let me just paste in that little bit of code that I got on the VooPlayer site. I'm going to click on update. I'm going to click on this link right here. And then it takes me to the home page, and there is my video. It's doing the autoplay right now. Okay. There we are. And you can see, let me pause it. You can see I don't see any of the YouTube logo or branding or anything like that. And I didn't customize the colors, but if you go to my website, you can see I've customized the colors for my own branding. But that's pretty much all there is to VooPlayer. Now, if I go back here, I can go back to my dashboard, and you can see right here the total amount of videos I have, how many sites they're embedded on. And you could see, I didn't mention this, but you can actually host up to 5 gigs of videos with VooPlayer. I've never used it. You can try it. I've never tried it. I'm sure it works great though. Here's a list of my total plays, and you can see one view or one play out of my allotment of 135,000. And here's some more stuff about your popular videos. Here would be a list of your videos. And you can click in here to see the different analytics of it. Now, obviously, I'm not going to have any analytics because I just literally put the video in, but you get some great analytics right here. Let me scroll down and see what else is there. And that's pretty much VooPlayer. Now, I didn't talk about this A-B split tests. That could be a big deal to someone that wants to use this on a sales page. So you can have a sales page. And if you wanted two different variations of the video and see which one converts better, you can use this A-B split testing feature. I don't use it, but I'll probably get into using that pretty soon. But the great thing about using VooPlayer for a sales page is you've got this detailed analytics, which is really what you want. Now, I currently use VooPlayer with that finish action. I use that a lot. For all my courses, I use that feature where it will remember where the person last left off in the video. So anyways, the purpose of this video wasn't so that I gave you some big giant sales pitch to get VooPlayer on my website. I did want to answer the question though of what do I use for my videos, and this is exactly what I use. And I do have some lifetime accounts available. It's only $99 and you can order it on my website, and I will create those accounts for you manually. And that's if you want to do this. You can, if you're not charging for your online course, you can just throw your videos up on YouTube. If you don't mind the branding and the stuff like that that it adds, just throw it up on YouTube. Or you can use any of the services that I mentioned in this video. But for me, I really like VooPlayer. I like the features I get with it. It's a good mix between features for an online course and features for a marketing or sales video or something like that. So anyways, this has been my video on ways to deliver the videos for your online courses. Hey, before you go, I have something for you. And before I get into that, I wanted to ask you to do something for me. If you could give me a thumbs up on this video. And if you're not a subscriber, click on the subscribe button right beneath me. If you have a question on this video, I'd be happy to answer it. You can also leave a comment or a question down below this video. Hey, I put together a course just for you, and I'm gonna give it to you for free. All you have to do is click on the button right here on the right. It's called the 3 Steps to WordPress Success. It's an awesome course. You're gonna love it. I would love for you to join in and enroll as a student in this course. Thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate it, and I do it just for you.